Try to help us do it. Lift your hands in this atmosphere and say, I am grateful.
I am grateful for the things
that you have done. Look at them and tell them.
Good morning. My name is Vincent Walker, Superintendent of Emanuel AME Sunday School, where Reverend John L. Deese Jr. is our pastor. This is Lesson 5 today on July 4th, 2021. Thank you. Thank you. A simple gesture, two simple words that can make a world of difference. Thank you. Growing up as a kid, my grandmother, my father, my aunts and uncles, those of, that were helping raise, those that were older than me, they stayed on me and my brothers and the younger ones in our families. When somebody gave us something or when somebody did something, I can remember vividly saying, what'd you say? Not what'd you say, what'd you say? Period. What'd you say? That's my family. What you say, what you say. And I'm doing the same thing, I've done the same thing with my child, to teach them gratitude, to say thank you. What you say, what you say, thank you. It was taught to us at an early age to show gratitude, to give thanks when somebody does something for you. In this lesson today, the subject is an attitude of gratitude. An attitude of gratitude. It is in Leviticus chapter 13 through 14, Luke chapter 5, verse 12 through 16, and Luke chapter 17, verses 11 through 9. That is the lesson. But the focus today, we're going to focus on Leviticus chapter 13, verses 45 and 46, and Luke chapter 17, verses 11 through 9. Leviticus talks about today. Today we're going to talk about gratitude. So Leviticus gives us a background on about leprosy, and how leprosy was sought by the Jews, sought by the people then, and you know, that the priests were in charge of, you know, who had leprosy, medication, how they had to be cast out, and if they, you know, were healed, you know, things of that sort. That the priests gave that say-so on leprosy. So we fast forward to Luke, and Jesus is on the walk with his disciples. They're traveling, and 10 lepers. So if you had leprosy, you were called a leper. So the leper shouted out, asking Jesus, Master, heal us, heal us. So Jesus, understand this, Jesus did not come to break the laws. Jesus did not come to say that the law, Jesus came to fulfill it, and Jesus still adhered and showed proper protocol. So Jesus told them, they were asking to be healed. Jesus said, go to the priest. Let me read it. They called out saying, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. When he saw them, he said to them, go show yourselves to the priest. Then I'll get there. He said, go show yourselves to the priest. Now, understand, they're asking to have mercy. They're asking to be healed. They're asking for mercy. They're asking to be healed. And he said, go show yourselves to the priest. Well, most people say, hey, I asked for healing. Why are you asking? Why are you telling me to go to the priest? Why? And most people, get that man. This dude ain't about nothing. I'm asking to be healed, and he gonna send me to a priest. Why? Obedience. Jesus said, go show yourself to the priest, because the priest was the one that can verify that they had been healed. The rest of the verse says, as they went, they were made clean. As they went, as they were obeying Jesus, they were made clean. Some of us, we ask Jesus for things, but we want it right there. We don't want to go through the process. We don't want to be obedient to his word, because Jesus has a plan. There's a plan for our life. You may be in a situation where you may be a couple hundred dollars short on your bills. Alright? And you say, Jesus, God, who God, I need you. I know you're going to make a way, God. What if God says, pack your bags. Pack your bags and take your family on vacation. Go visit somebody. Go do it. Go stay in this hotel. And while you're there, go visit your family. God, I told you I was short on money. Why are you making me spend money? Little did you know that when you get there, somebody had some money for you. Somebody wanted to bless you while you were there. See, follow God. Follow the plan. Because when you're asking for something, you're obviously asking him because you don't know how you're going to do it. He knows how he's going to do it, so you need to follow him. That's one point. Follow him. Be obedient. All right, now let's get to this gratitude part. So they were made clean. They were made clean on their way. And as they were made clean, when they were made clean, one of them came back, the Samaritan. Now understand this and remember this. Samaritans and Jews did not mix. They did not mix. But the Samaritan came back and gave thanks. And Jesus said, wasn't 10 of you made whole? But only one came and showed gratitude. Only one. And Jesus said in verse 19, then he said to him, get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well. See, all of them, really, all of them had faith in Jesus for him to heal them. Then they got up, they did what he said, and they were made whole. But one came back and gave gratitude. One came back and gave gratitude. As a parent, you have kids, you have your kids' friends over, and you giving them some, and the only one that says thank you is your kid's friend. Your kids just think, this is my mama. She's supposed to do this. This is my daddy. He's supposed to do this. No. Children, well, no matter what age you are, when your parents do something for you, when somebody does something for you, show some gratitude. Two simple words. Thank you. Put it together. Thank you. It goes a long way. Stop thinking you're old things in life. Show some gratitude. Show simple gratitude. Now, parents, imagine how that make you feel when everybody's saying thank you and your kids are just sitting there, oh, come on, y'all, get this and ride on back to their room or ride on back outside. But the other kids or the child that's over there to visit your child said, thank you, Miss So-and-so. Thank you, Mr. So-and-so. But your kid ain't gone. Imagine how that make you feel. Imagine how that makes God feel when you don't say thank you. Because so many of us, we pray for things, and when we get the things that we want from God, we say thank you then, but we don't continue to live in that gratification, knowing that God did it for us. We want it, we get it, we don't say thank you. Come on. Two simple words. Two simple words. Say thank you, Lord. Say thank you, Jesus. Just say it. That's all. Because that right there, that shows God that you're appreciative over what he did, and it also shows the enemy that you know where your blessings came from. It shows the enemy, it shows the devil that you know that God gave you this and the world didn't give it to you. Because too often, when you're not giving God gratitude, you're giving the world gratitude. It's no gray area. There is no gray area. If you're not thanking God for it, you're thanking the devil for it. I'm just telling you like it is. It's no gray area. You're thanking God or you're thanking the enemy. And if you don't thank God, the enemy's like, oh yeah, ain't realizing I got that for him. God, ain't no God wasn't even worried about them, so they know I'm taking care of them. I'm telling you like it is. An attitude of gratitude to the Most High, to the King of Kings, to the Lord of Lords. Not, what I said, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and not the Prince of Darkness. The Prince, why are you going to give thanks to a prince? Give thanks to the King of Kings. Have a blessed day, my brothers and sisters. Amen.